Thank you. right in front of me now. Azad supermarket. Deepak. How did you all know Deepak first? Then? Check if he doesn't just come back.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I was not telling he doesn't know us. Dad was the first person he met when he came to the parish from Maroli. Father Clement. Hubert Mosquito is dead.
Thank you. the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Praise be God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of all mercies, the God of all consolation. He comforts those who are in trouble. With the same consolation we ourselves have received from him. Dear brothers and sisters, we spend a few moments in silence thanking God for the gift that Herbert was to, first of all, his family, to the community that he lived in, to the parish, to all of us who are gathered here, that we will really and truly remember him, praise God, and thank him for the gift that he was to all of us. Quiet, unassuming, always ready to help, strong in the faith, loyal. Hear our response now. Be Lord, remember me in your kingdom. Together.
Lord, remember me in your kingdom.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures, where he gives me repose. Near restful waters he leads me to revive my drooping spirit. Lord, remember me in your kingdom. He guides me along the right path, he is true to his name. If I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil would I fear. You are there with your crook and your staff. With these you give me comfort. Lord, remember me in your kingdom. You have prepared a banquet for me in the sight of my foes. My head you have anointed with oil. My cup is overflowing. Lord,
remember me in your kingdom.
Surely goodness and kindness shall follow me all the days of my life. In the Lord's own house shall I dwell forever and ever. Lord,
remember me in your kingdom.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us pray. Lord, hear our prayers and be merciful to your son, Herbert, whom you have called from this life. Welcome him into the company of your saints in the kingdom of light and peace. We ask you this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord.
And
may his soul rest in peace.
Amen.
Let's pray now as for all of us present here. Father God of all consolation, in your unending love and mercy for us, you turn the darkness of death into the dawn of new life. Show compassion to your people gathered here in their sorrow. Be our refuge and our strength to lift us from the darkness of this grief to the peace and light of your presence. Your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by dying for us conquered death and by rising again restored life. May we then go forward eagerly to meet him, and after our life on earth be reunited with our brothers and sisters, where every tear will be wiped away. We ask you this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord.
And
may his soul rest in peace.
Amen.
May his soul and the souls of all the faithful depart to the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen.
Move now to the church for Mass.
kindly stand. Your entrance hymn shall be Come Back to Me.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, when someone who is close to you, lives with you, worships with you, shares with you life, disappears, goes away, it is a difficult kind of parting. And Herbert has been a very strong, staunch pillar of the church, pillar of the community. He has been there for people, for the community, for the church. As we will miss him as he moves away from this life, we are assured by Jesus that he will continue to live in our hearts, supporting us, prompting us, allowing us, enabling us to do the will of God. For those moments that we have failed to listen to the voice of the Lord, we ask him now to forgive us. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. May he forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who alone are able to give life after death, free your servant Herbert from all sins, that he who believed in the resurrection of your Christ may, when the day of resurrection comes, be united with you in glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please sit.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will prepare for all peoples a banquet of rich food. On this mountain, he will remove the mourning veil covering all peoples and the shroud enwrapping all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord will wipe away the tears from every cheek. He will take away his people's shame everywhere on earth, for the Lord has said so. That day, it will be said, see, this is our God in whom we hoped for salvation. The Lord is the one in whom we hoped. We exult and we rejoice that he has saved us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gives me
please stand.
From the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus said to the crowd, "All that the Father gives me will come to me, and whoever comes to me, I shall not turn him away, because I have come from heaven, not to do my will, but to do the will of the one who sent me. Now, the will of him who sent me is that I should lose nothing of all that he has given me, and that I should raise it up on the last day. Yes, it is my Father's will, that whoever sees the Son and believes in him shall have eternal life, and that I shall raise him up on the last day." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Sometimes we live religion as a routine. And sometimes we might even ask ourselves, why this routine in religion? Why this religious practice? But then in some moments we realize that it's not just a routine. It's not just a tradition. It's not just something that it's part of our culture or it has been taught to us. But it's really part of our life. In some occasions, we encounter life and we encounter death. And then we realize that we are trying to make sense of this. We are trying to make sense of our joys and of our sadness. We are trying to make sense and find the direction for our life. And in an occasion like this, we are here to say, okay, I'm bringing my feelings, I'm bringing my experience, the feelings of having seen going away a friend, a colleague, a father, a husband. And why? And it's so difficult for us because we have this desire for eternity. It's so difficult, this moment is so difficult for us, because we have this desire for eternity. But the good news is that this desire is not in vain. We could not have it, but we have this desire for eternity because it was given by God, because we were made for eternity. Each one of us, we are made for eternity. That's why death is so difficult, because we were made for eternity and we desire eternity. But the good news is that, and we are here in this rite, in this moment, to think about eternity and to encounter Him, God, who is telling us death is not the end. Jesus is saying in today's gospel, "I shall not turn away anyone who comes to me, because I did not come to do my will, the will of the one who sent me." So the good news that Jesus is telling us in this gospel is that death is not the end. That this life is a passage. We are passing through it. But the real life is in the other side. The real life is yet to come. And now our brother Herbert has entered that life. And we are here to pray for him so he can pass easily and reach this peace and this joy of God. But our faith is that it's not the end. Our faith is that he will come with God. And one day we are also journeying to that. I remember 1 year back when Joanna called me and she said that they had discovered his sickness. And the way that she told me was that I thought it would be something, it was serious, no, the cancer and all that. So I thought it would be fast. Instead, I think God gave him time. God gave him time to spend with his family. God gave him time to prepare himself and maybe for us to complete this walking with him. And I think he could complete this cycle, no? The cycle of life. So, and even this coincidence of passing away, completing the cycle of life and passing away the day of his birthday, which is an interesting coincidence, but maybe wants to tell us how life is a cycle. One day we'll have to go. The important thing is that we can live a meaningful life. And we can complete our journey, we can complete our mission in a peaceful way. I think he was able to do this. And for this, we should have peace. We should have even this understanding or even this gratitude to say that he has lived a beautiful life, a meaningful life, and he has completed. As St. Paul was saying, I will complete the course of my life and I will give it back to Jesus. So like this, he can give the fruit of his life back to Jesus and do this passing in a peaceful manner. And for each one of us who are still walking, we should take this opportunity to think about life and see how it passes. So this, the same day we lost two great people from our community, you know, Natu and Herbert. So this makes us realize how life is passing, but we should live in a meaningful way. So when our moment comes, we can, in a peaceful manner, say that we have followed what Jesus is telling, so we can trust in his words that we will do the passing of this life in a peaceful way, and we will encounter. We will meet him in the other side, where, as the first reading says, all the tears will be washed away. Where all the joy will be with us, the suffering will go. So may we walk in a meaningful manner, following the teachings of Jesus, so we can complete this life in a peaceful way. One day we'll all be gathered again with our brother there in the kingdom of heaven. In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
Lord, accept the sacrifice in your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good of all his holy church.
Let us pray, Almighty and merciful God, by the means of these sacrificial offerings, wash away, we pray, in the blood of Christ, the sins of your departed servant, Herbert, and purify unceasingly by your merciful forgiveness those you once cleansed in the waters of baptism. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as one alone he accepted death, so that we might all escape from dying. As one man he chose to die, so that in your sight we all might live forever. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Stand. The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Oswald, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Herbert Andrew Coates, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united to your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our other brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
While we pray for Herbert, we believe as Christians that he's already in the presence of the Lord. Remember in a very special way his family, Blossom and Joanna. Pray for ourselves that our faith in Jesus and his resurrection will hold good for each one of us. Pray together. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, is now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church gathered here, and graciously grant a peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Communion is only for Catholics.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Your communion hymn shall be, in moments like these, Holy Communion is only for Catholics, people of other faith, please join us in singing.
Let us pray. Having received the sacrament of your only begotten Son, who was sacrificed for us and rose in glory, we humbly implore you, O Lord, for your departed servant, Herbert, that cleansed by the paschal mysteries, he may glory in the gift of the resurrection to come, through Christ our Lord. Please sit for a moment.
Good evening. Excuse me for using this paper, but I get very emotional when I speak. My name is Jack Alves. I'm a very close friend of Herbert and the family. I would like to thank Blossom and Joanna for giving me the honor to speak to the only person they care and love, Herbert. I met Herbert in the late 70s, and ever since we've been best of friends. In fact, Herbert is now part of a small group called the Jazzy Club. Herbert, in his childhood and even later on in life, was a very good sportsman. He played all the games possible. But I think that he excelled in hockey. And no wonder he was made captain of State Bank of India, where he worked throughout his life, rose up to be manager of the various banks. I kept meeting him when I used to travel. I worked in various places and Herbert used to come and see me when he attended conferences, etc. Herbert loved his family. And he gave them the very best. Blossom told me yesterday that Herbert was a very patient man. And that quality helped the family to carry on life to the fullest. He was also a very religious man. I know him personally. Whenever we went to Goa, we would always want to visit the Bon Jesu shrine and all the churches. And I've been told he's very active in this church, in all the committees, and so did Father say earlier. He was in the finance committee and everyone trusted Herbert. But he did not stop there. He extended his help to anyone who came to him, especially when there were problems with banking. I myself am a beneficiary of the same. His smile was infectious, and yet he stood for what is right. I did put his post on Facebook about his demise. And you should have seen the wonderful comments he received from friends all over the world. We will all miss Herbert tremendously, but I know he is now in a better place. You are gone too soon, and I look forward to the day I will see you again. Rest easy, my friend. We all love you. You fought so well. You loved so deeply. You lived life to the fullest. No one that has ever known you will forget you, Herbert. I know I never will. The month's wine mass will be in this church at 7 p.m. on the 30th of December 22. There's a bus that has been arranged to take those who wish to come to the burial at Oshiwara. On behalf of Blossom and Joanna, I would like to thank the priest, Father Clement, and Father Matthew. Thank you.
We will do our final commendation and our final farewell for our brother Herbert. With faith in Jesus Christ, we reverently bring the body of our brother Herbert to be buried in this human imperfection. Let us pray with confidence to God, who gives life to all things, that he will rise up this mortal body to the perfection and to the company of the saints. May God give him a merciful judgment, forgive all his sins. May Christ, the Good Shepherd, lead him safely home to be at peace with God our Father. And may he be happy forever with all the saints in the presence of the Eternal King. We'll pray for him, and our response will be, receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. His soul and present him to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to his aid. Come to meet him, angels of Lord. His soul and present him to the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to Abraham's side. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Give him eternal rest, O Lord, and may your light shine on him forever. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Father, into your hands we commend our brother. We are confident that with all who have died in Christ, he will be raised to the life on the last day and live with Christ forever. We thank you for all the blessings you have given him in his life, to show your fatherly care for all of us and the fellowship which is ours with the saints in Jesus Christ. Lord, hear our prayer. Welcome our brother Herbert to paradise, and help us to comfort each other with the assurance of our faith, until we all meet with Christ, to be with you and with our brother Herbert forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May the angels lead you into the paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. Amen.
We move now to the cemetery for the burial.
For our recessional hymn, we shall take In His Time.
Thank you. closer this one.
Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, that the 3 days you lay in the tomb, you made holy the graves of all who believe in you. And even though their bodies lie in the earth, they trust that they, like you, will rise again. Give our brother Herbert peaceful rest in his grave until that day when you, the resurrection and the life, will raise him up in glory. Then may he see the light of your presence, Lord Jesus, in the kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
Since Almighty God has called our brother Herbert from this life to himself, he commit his body to the earth from which it was made. Christ was the first to rise from the dead, and we know that he will raise up our mortal bodies to be like his in glory. We commend our brother to the Lord. May the Lord receive him into his peace and raise up his body on the last day. Let us pray for our brother, to our Lord Jesus Christ, who said, I am the resurrection and the life. The man who believes in me will live, even if he dies. And every living person who puts his faith in me will never suffer eternal death. Let our response now be, Lord, hear our prayer. All together.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Herbert was nourished with your body and blood. Grant him a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, you wept at the death of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
You raised the dead to life. Give our brother Herbert eternal life. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
You promised paradise to the people who repented. Bring our brother to the joys of heaven. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our brother Herbert was washed clean in baptism and anointed with the oil of salvation. Give him fellowship with all your saints. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Comfort us, Lord, in our sorrow at the death of our brother. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We say now the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father,
the Lord in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Let us pray. Lord, listen to our prayers for our brother Herbert. As he always desired to do your will, so in your mercy forgive whatever wrong he may have done. By his Christian faith he was united with all your believing people. Now in love and mercy give him a place with your angels and saints. We ask you this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. May his soul rest in peace.
Amen.
May his soul and the souls of all the faithful depart to the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen.
Thank you.
sacrifice for the 3 days you lay in the tomb.
You should not get caught up.
And even though their bodies lie here, they cross the day like you will not tonight. Give our brother Herbert a peaceful rest in his grave. And with that day, the resurrection of the life, they will raise him up in glory. Then may he see the light of your presence, Lord Jesus, the kingdom where you live.
Just a passing through. My treasures are laid up somewhere beyond the blue. The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Oh Lord, you know I have no friend like you. If heaven's not my home, and Lord, what will I do? The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. I have a loving mother just over in glory land, and I don't expect to stop until I shake her hand. She's waiting now for me open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Oh Lord, you know I have no friend like you.
Was free.
grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious is that grace of fear. The hour I first thus far, and praise.